Hi, this is Heidi Krug, Director of Supports for Instruction for Smarter Balanced. We're excited to announce the launch of our new and improved search feature within the digital library. And the purpose of this video is just to give you a little bit of a demonstration and a walkthrough. So in the new search, the first step is going to be to select the type of resource you're interested in. And we have three types. We have instructional resources, professional learning resources, and then we have our playlists. So you can navigate to the search page for each of these resource types by clicking anywhere in the three fields or on the tabs up here in the white bar. Now the search functions in the exact same way for each of the three resource types. So I'm just going to demonstrate by showing you the instructional resources page. So this is the new and improved search page. You'll see the different filters are located on the left-hand side of the panel, and the search results are located here. So you may notice if you jump in that you have a number of different subject area and grade levels already selected the first time you use the new search experience. Now this is because these have been ported over from your user profile. So when you first set up your digital library account, there are a couple of questions there about the subject areas that you're interested in and the grade levels. Now we've borrowed that information here so you don't have to select it each time you want to go in and find a resource, and we're going to save you a little bit of time. Now let's say you change grade level or subject area, or you just want to update your user profile. You can do that at absolutely any time. You just click on your name at the top of the panel, click there, and then go through the expertise questions. You can change it, and it'll update it here automatically. So in this example, I'm a teacher who's interested in third, fourth grade, and fifth grade resources. So you can see here in this gray bar that we have 567 results based on my pre-selections for subject area and grade level. So you're welcome to look through all of the different resources here and click through the different pages, but if you're a typical teacher and time is tight, which I'm absolutely sure it is, you want to hone in on a smaller number of results. So I'm going to show you how to do that. First thing is, let's say you're interested in just fifth grade resources, you can just deselect third and fourth grade, and it'll go down to 255. Now I want to show you all the other options you have for filtering your results. So you could filter according to the assessment target alignment, Common Core State Standard, media type. There are a number of different options that you can use here to kind of hone in on the resources that you're most interested in at the time. So I'm going to demonstrate how you might just be interested in videos, let's say, that you could use in the classroom. And maybe you just want to use classroom activity or assignment resources. So just with a couple of clicks, we're down to 10 results. So I want to show you that you can also search within your results by using a search string. So let's say you just want to look for resources that focus on fractions. Click return. And it turns out that there are three. So this is a more manageable number of resources to look through. So the resources are shown here in these different resource cards. They're just three stacked on top of each other. And for each resource, you're going to see high-level information. For example, the title of the resource, the subject area, grade level, the date it was posted, and a brief description about it. On the right, you can see the number of times digital library users have viewed the resource and downloaded it. You can also sort results by putting the newest at the top, most viewed, most downloaded, or highest rated. So this is another option you have for displaying your results. And when you're ready, when you found a resource that you're really excited about, you can click on the title or click on the icon to access the resource page. And there you can download all the information you need to go ahead and use the resource. And then we'll ask that you come back and give it a star rating. So that's it. Thanks for taking the time to view this short video about the new search feature. We're hopeful that you're going to find the digital library a useful part of your day-to-day planning activities.